Come on, I see you and say, you know what? There is a way out. There's a way out for us all. If you just do that. You just
follow Jesus.
Jesus, 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 Jesus. I'll tell you, Jesus. He's all deny him. He's all deny him. Well, just deny him. Deny him. But that is the he's what he'll be doing, because I'll tell you what, just shout his name out and I'll tell you, he'll come and meet with you wherever your life's at. Honestly, wherever your life's at, he'll come and meet with you. He will, he'll come and meet with you. Whatever your circumstances, whatever you're going through, he'll come and meet with you. He'll come and meet me and he'll say, do you know what? I love you. Doesn't matter what you've done. Doesn't matter where you've been. It doesn't matter what you've... Whatever. He'll say, do you know what? I love you. He'll smile on you. He'll care for you. And he'll love you. And that's what I see life as, right? He just loves you, he bits. He loves you, he bits. He just wants to say, do you know what? Doesn't matter. We're all joke caps as bairns, if you like, right? But he still says, just come into my phone. Come into my phone now.
Come into my life.
Come into my life. Come into my heart, Lord Jesus. As a wee saying I used to say as a wee, right? He says, come in, come in, come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Right? But a lot of people don't get that nowadays because they think it's too kind of childlike. Right? So what if it's childlike? I'll tell you what. Be like a child and just come to Jesus as a child. And you know what? No way he'll do. He'll go like that to you. He'll say, do you know what? He'll say, just come like a child. Just come like a child, just come like a child. And that's it, just come like a child. But I'll tell you what, he loves you. He loves you. And he will always love you.
Amen.
I know because I've experienced Jesus Christ in my life. As in the soul part of you. It's not just about your heart, it's not just about, it's about feeling right in life and going by yourself. Do you know what? I love life.
The blood of Jesus, what can make you whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. How precious is that flow that makes you wash away all your gifts and all. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can wash away your sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make you whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. How precious is that flow that makes me white as snow? When the world gives out, nothing but the blood of Jesus. Majesty, worship His majesty.
Loving you. We are, you know how you guys love That's the most important thing about God. It says in the Bible that God is love. All of us need to be loved and feel loved. Some of us want to do it through physical means. And this is into all kind of trouble doing that. God wants to love you from the inside. God knows who you are, He created you. And when you accept that love that Jesus showed you on the cross at Calvary, He pours out His love through His Spirit into your life. And God's love is a pure love, a righteous love, a love which never dies. As long as we are prepared to keep being honest and admit our sin before God. I'm the first one to admit I'm a sinner. And this is the key. If you read the First John, the Apostle, he says that if you say you haven't sinned, you're a liar and the truth is not in you. And so you must confess that we're sinners before God, because we know and God knows that we've sinned, but He wants to forgive you. He wants to bring us into that salvation. It's a free gift. A lot of religions teach you that you should work for your salvation. If you're a good person, you get into heaven. It's not what the Bible teaches. Salvation is a free gift. God knows we fall short. Every single day I fall short of God's glory. And God keeps pouring out His grace to me in order that I can keep enjoying God. And He keeps pouring out His love on me to love other people. And so that's how things should be in the world, isn't it? Because it's a very mixed up and sinful world. It's just that God's love. When I heard that Jesus loved me, that was what really got me to God. I wasn't interested in going to a church or having a religion and all that. When I heard about God's love, and it was made real to me, and I understood God's love through Jesus Christ, that's what brought me to salvation. Don't think for a second that I don't think I'm righteous or special or anything. All I'm a blood-bought Christian by the blood of the Lamb, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. I'm a blood-bought Christian. I venerate Jesus Christ. I'm a born-again Christian. Jesus said, a man must be born again to inherit the kingdom of God. Very simple. And when we humble ourselves before God, submit to His word, ask Jesus into our life, that's it. But then we've got to keep on believing and trusting in Him. Hallelujah. And it says even, I believe in Islam, there's very many surahs in there talking about Jesus. That Surah 355 talks about God speaking to Jesus, I shall cause you to die. I shall contend against those who contended against you. I shall exalt your followers more than any other prophet. You see, that's what it says in the Quran. So I can teach, I can show people Jesus from the Quran, from the Bible. The Vedas is the Prajapati sacrifice in the religion of Hinduism. That God gives a part of Himself to die for the sins of His people. And that's what brings many Hindus to Jesus, realizing Jesus was the only one who died for their sin. It wasn't Buddha, it wasn't Muhammad, it wasn't any other of these prophets. It was Jesus Christ who died for their sin. Hallelujah. You want to learn more about Jesus? Come and speak to me. Take a flyer, whatever you want to do. Sell music as well, which should help you in your walk. Acoustic rap and hip hop music for a small donation as well. So the important thing is that you make your decision for Jesus today. It says in the Bible that salvation is for now. Don't put off until tomorrow. Salvation is for today. Praise God. God loves you. I'm John, how you doing?
Caroline, how you doing, pal?